My dear brothers and respected elders, Allah is our Rabb. And Rabb in Arabic is a very comprehensive word which means the sustainer, the nourisher, the one who looks after, the one who provides, the one who feeds. And this is a sifat of Allah, this is a quality attribute of Allah. And this is such a sifat of Allah, Allah begins the Quran, His word, with this sifat. And where the Quran ends, Allah also mentions this sifat. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Qul a'udhu bi Rabbin Nas. And long before Allah even sent us to this world, when people were still in the world of the souls, Allah gathered all the souls and put forward a question. And that question was, Alastu bi Rabbikum. Am I not your Lord? Am I not your Rabb? And then Allah sent us to this world and sent guidance. And for us, for this ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, Allah has sent the glorious Quran. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said in one hadith, for every nation there is a matter of pride. And the matter of pride for my nation is the Quran. فضل كلام الله على سائر الكلام كفضل الله على خلقه. The virtue of the Quran over everything else is like that of Allah Himself over His makhluk. There is simply no comparison between Allah and His makhluk. Similarly, there is absolutely no comparison between the Quran and anything else. There is a saying, كلام الملوك ملوك الكلام. The words of the kings are the kings of the words. بادشاہوں کی باتیں باتوں کی بادشاہ ہوتی ہیں کلام الملوک ملوک الکلام and there is no bigger king than Allah, so there is no bigger word than the word of Allah. And so when Allah revealed the Quran for the guidance of people, hudal linnas, the Quran is guidance for the whole of mankind, wabayyinatin minal huda wal furqan, and the Quran makes clear what is haq, what is batil, what is good, what is bad, what is useful to you, what is harmful to you, what is really yours, who is your friend, who is your enemy, and shaitan is your biggest enemy. إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ لَكُمْ عَدُوٌ فَاتَّخِذُوهُ عَدُوًّا. Shaitan is your number one enemy. Other people, sometimes they are your enemies and then they can even become your friends. Sometimes even the best of the friends can become the worst of the enemies. And such friends are very dangerous because they know all about you. But shaitan, Allah says in the Quran, he is your main enemy. He is your main enemy. And your best friend, you know who is our best friend? Allah is our best friend. Allahu waliyyu alladhina amanu. Allah is the friend of the believers. Yukhrijuhum min al-zulumati ila al-nur. Allah has no benefit in us. Allah ka kuch fayda nahi humse. Allah cannot gain any benefit from us. We cannot benefit Allah in any way whatsoever. So whosoever believes in Allah and worships Him and obeys Him, man amila salihan fali nafsi, it is for his own good. So Allah has revealed the Quran for the guidance and benefit of the whole of mankind. And then Allah began the Quran. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Be aware, be conscious, whatever happens in this world, all happens with the will of Allah. Whatever good takes place, all the credit goes to Allah. Qul a'udhu bi Rabbin Nas. And all the people of the world, Allah is the one who looks after them. When you want anything, Rabbana, 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 turn to your Lord and pray to Him, Ya Allah, You are the one who provides and gives. You are the best of the givers. Khairul Rahimeen, Khairul Raziqeen, Khairul Hafizeen, the best of the protectors, the best of the providers, the best of Khairul Nasireen, the best of the helpers. Throughout the Quran, Allah has mentioned the word Rabb. Ulama say no less than 700-800 times. 700-800 times. And then as soon as people leave this world and they're put in their graves, you know what the first question is? Mar Rabbuka, who is your Rabb? Who is your Rabb? The first question there was, who is your, am I not your Rabb? And everybody agreed. Qalu bala, Ya Allah, indeed, there is no doubt you are our Rabb. قالوا بلا بلا in Arabic, in like you say in English, undoubtedly. Koi shak shubha nahi. There is no doubt whatsoever. Ya Allah, you are our Rabb. Nobody else is our Rabb. You are our Rabb. Because there were no factories, there were no shops, there were no parents, there were no children, and there was nothing else that people could see and people could feel. Allah used to look after the people directly with His Amr. So it was easy to declare, Ya Allah, yes, you are our Rabb. Then Allah sent us to this world and put things around us and gave people strength. وَالَّذِي خَلَقَكُم مِّن ضَعْفٍ ثُمَّ جَعَلَ مِن بَعْدِ ضَعْفٍ قُوَّةٍ. Made from weakness, فَلْيَنْظُرِ الْإِنسَانُ مِمَّ خُلِقْ. Oh insan, why don't you look into yourself? What are you? What are you? What is it in you which makes you so proud of yourself? What is it in you? Do you have anything in you that you deserve to be proud? Look at you, what are you? فَلْيَنْظُرِ الْإِنسَانُ مِمَّ خُلِقْ أَخُلِقَ مِمَّا إِنْ دَافِقْ أَلَمْ نَخْلُقُمْ مِمَّا إِنْ مَهِينٍ ثُمَّ جَعَلْنَاهُ نُطْفَةً فِي قَرَارٍ مَكِينٍ. From nutfa, from a dirty fluid. And look how Allah fashioned you, how Allah made you. هُوَ الَّذِي يُصَوِّرُكُمْ فِي الْأَرْحَامِ كَيْفَ يَشَاءُ. How He fashioned you, made you. MashaAllah, gave you such wonderful looks. Gave you a face with eyes to see, and a nose to smell, and a mouth to speak, and a tongue to talk with. MashaAllah, how Allah fashioned you so wonderfully. فَسَوَّاكَ فَعَدَلَكَ فِي أَيِّ سُورَةٍ مَا شَاءَ رَكَّبَكَ. How Allah made everything in moderation, in the perfect form and place. And then look at yourself. مَا غَرَّكَ بِرَبِّكَ الْكَرِيمِ. What's taken you away from your Lord? From your Rabb. مَا غَرَّكَ بِرَبِّكَ الْكَرِيمِ. Here again Allah mentions his sifa Rabb. And how Allah made people, and Allah put everything in place. Some people Allah gave strength, some intelligence, some Allah made in good family, some Allah gave plenty of wealth, some Allah didn't give anything. And Allah made all this world run smoothly around you. And then, as soon as a person leaves this world, having experienced whatever he did, lived a life in whatever form, acquired so much wealth, did so much, but then when he leaves this world and is put into the grave, and the angels come, and what angels they are, Allahu Akbar, may Allah protect us, such with fiery eyes, flames flowing out of their mouths. Our ulama have described the appearance of Munkir Nakir, such long horrific hair, fangs sticking out of their mouths, and flames, and they speak with such horror, and like when they open their mouths and they question as though thunder and lightning strikes, and they will say to the person who's been buried, sit up, and the person will sit up. And that in that horrific form they will inquire, Man Rabbuka? Who is your Lord? Not Man Khaliquka? Man Ilahuka? Man Rabbuka? And a person then won't speak with this tongue, because with this tongue, يَقُولُونَ بِأَفْوَاهِهِمْ مَا لَيْسَ فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ. How many a times people speak with their tongues what they don't really mean. In their hearts they hold other wishes and desires, but with their tongues they speak something else. With their tongues they speak something else. They meet somebody and he makes salam. Ah, MashaAllah, so nice to see you. And in their heart he's saying, man, get out of my way. Why are you wasting my time? MashaAllah, somebody phoned somebody at night 11. Oh, MashaAllah, brother, so nice of you to phone. I've been thinking about you recently. And in his heart he's saying, man, look, is this the time to phone anyone? When somebody goes to somebody's house and knocks, is Mr. So-and-so in? He sends his son out, tell him daddy's not in. But children are innocent. Children say, my dad says he's not in. My dad says he's not in. So you people won't be able to speak in the grave like that. وَحُسَّلَ مَا فِي الصُّدُورِ. It's what a person has recorded in his heart. There is a tape. Whatever a person says, whatever a person sees, whatever a person hears and does, and even thinks, it's all being recorded, being taped. CCTV. MashaAllah, everywhere. England is, MashaAllah, the most observed nation in the world. English people. There's a CCTV around every corner. Allah has also put down CCTVs everywhere. There are angels. وَإِنَّ عَلَيْكُمْ لَحَافِظِينَ كِرَامًا كَاتِبِينَ يَعْلَمُونَ مَا تَفَعَلُونَ. And they know exactly what you say. They know exactly what you do. It's all being recorded. مَا يَلْفِظُ مِنْ قَوْلٍ. Not a word is uttered without being saved and preserved and recorded. So it's all there in the report. And it's all being recorded down under as well. And when a person enters the grave, it's not this tongue which will answer. This tongue will answer, but reflect what's being recorded in here. And what's being recorded in here, that is what will then come out. It's like when you play a button on a CD or a tape recorder, just because you bought something from Makkah, it doesn't automatically mean it's going to play music, or it's going to play Quran. Because you bought something in London, it doesn't automatically mean it's going to play pop music. You can buy a CD from London and play Quran in it. You can buy music from Makkah and it will play music. So whatever has been recorded in here, that is what will come out in the grave. A person who's recognized Allah as his Lord, as his Creator and Master, and lived his life the way Allah wanted him to live, doing things Allah wanted him to do, praying 5 times a day, reciting Quran, paying zakat, performing hajj if a person can afford to do so, fasting in the month of Ramadan, eating halal, refraining from haram, speaking the truth and refraining from lies, from backbiting, from slandering. أَيُحِبُّ أَحَدُكُمْ أَنْ يَأْكُلَ لَحْمَ أَخِيهِ مَيْتًا فَكَرِهْتُمُوهُ. How would you like to eat the dead meat of your brother? Can you imagine his corpse lying and you cut out a pound of meat from somebody's dead body and eat it? This is what ghibat is. Ghibat. And then bohtan. Bohtan is to say something which is not right. Ghibat is to say something which is true. But if the person was there, he wouldn't like the way you're talking about him. Even though it is true, that's ghibah. Wal ghibatu ashaddu min az-zina. And it's even worse than zina. And bohtan is even worse, even more severe. If a person slanders, accuses someone wrongly of anything, on the day of Qiyamah, he will have to prove his claim, his accusation. So lying, refraining from haram, eating halal, speaking the truth, and refraining from lies. أَنَا زَعِيمٌ بِبَيْتٍ فِي رَبَضِ الْجَنَّةِ لِمَنْ تَرَكَ الْمِرَاءَ وَإِنْ كَانَ مُحِقَّةً. The Prophet ﷺ said, I, Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, personally take guarantee and assurance to ensure, and I guarantee someone a palace on the outskirts of Jannah for someone who doesn't argue even though he is right. There is an argument, someone is wrong, someone is right, but you know you are right and you can put up an argument, you can put up a defense, but you don't, because you don't want to argue with your Muslim brother, you don't want to fight with him, you don't want to raise your voice at him, and you walk away because of this simple amal. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam will intercede on your behalf on the day of Qiyamah and make sure that Allah gives you a palace on the outskirts of Jannah. وَبِبَيْتٍ فِي وَسَطِ الْجَنَّةِ لِمَنْ تَرَكَ الْكَذِبَ وَإِنْ كَانَ مَازِهًا. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, I, Muhammadur Rasulullah, take assurance and give guarantee for a palace in the middle of Jannah for someone who doesn't lie even as a joke. And most jokes are lies. Nothing happened. Oh, he went there and he said this and this happened and everybody starts laughing. And none of it is true. It's all a lie. And people tell jokes to make others laugh. And they ruin their own aqibah. Apni aqibat kharab karte hain doosro ko hansane ke liye. Apna kuch fayda nahi. And they just make fun of him. And the person who tells the most jokes becomes a joker, becomes a clown. And then no one takes him seriously. So if a person doesn't lie even as a joke and nothing speaks from the tongue except the truth, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, simply this amal is such, not speaking lies is such an amal. The beloved Prophet of Allah, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Khatimun Nabiyyin rahmatul lil alamin, will make shafaat for you and get you a palace in the middle of Jannah. وَبِبَيْتٍ فِي أَعْلَى الْجَنَّةِ لِمَنْ حَسُنَ خُلُقًا. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, I, Muhammadur Rasulullah, I take assurance and give guarantee for a palace in the highest ranks of Jannah, in Jannatul Firdaus, in the neighborhood of prophets and anbiya and salihin, for someone who has good character, who speaks well, mashallah. When you greet someone with a smile, you're helpful, truthful, polite, respectful. These are good akhlaqs. And Allah swears by the akhlaq of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Surah Noon, the second surah to be revealed after Iqra, the second revelation. Noon wal qalami wa ma yasturun, ma anta bi ni'mati rabbika bi majnun, wa inna laka la ajran ghayra mamnun, wa innaka la ala khuluqin azim. Oh my beloved Prophet, I swear by the pen and what people will write. You are not crazy, you are not mad, you are on such wonderful and supreme and sublime character. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّمَا بُعِثْتُ لِأُتَمِّمَ مَكَارِمَ الْأَخْلَاقِ. Allah has sent me to complete, to teach people how to live with each other, how to deal with one another, how to acquire good manners. And the people with the best manners and morals, they are the ones whose amal will be the weightiest in the scale of deeds, and who will command the highest ranks in Jannah. The ones who have good akhlaq. When you meet someone, mashallah, to take the initiative, and to take the lead in making salam, not wait for others to make salam to you. There was no one better to walk on the surface of the earth than Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But the beloved Prophet of Allah would always take the initiative in making salam. Making salam to his wives, making salam to children, making salam to strangers, making salam to youngsters, to everybody. Anybody the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would see and meet, he would immediately say salam. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came from Makkah to Medina, and the people heard, obviously the Ansar who had already embraced Islam, and they went out of Medina to welcome the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But there was a large Jewish community in Madinatul Munawwara, and many of them were ulama of Torah and Injil. And among them, someone highly respected in the Jewish community from a very respectable family was Abdullah bin Salam. Later on he became a Muslim. And when he heard about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he came to see him. And the first thing Abdullah bin Salam radiallahu anhu used to say, I heard the Prophet saying, was, Afshu salam, spread salam amongst yourselves. Afshu salam, wa at'imu at'am, feed one another. Afshu salam, wa at'imu at'am, wasilu al-arham. And maintain ties. Tie your ties, your relations, your kins, your brothers and sisters, uncles and aunts, the close relatives, keep ties with them. Those who cut off ties, ulaika lahumul la'na. Allah has cursed the people who cut off ties with close relatives. And so he heard the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, afshu salam wa at'imu at'am wasilu al-arham wa sallu wan-nasu nayam, and say some prayer when people are asleep in the darkness of the night. Tadkhulu al-jannata bi salam. Shortcut to Jannah. You go straight to Jannah without any reckoning, without any hisab, without any problem. A person who can do these four things. Spread salam, feed other people, feeding friends, relatives, mashallah. Feeding, entertaining people, entertaining guests, especially. Such a noble and a dear deed to Allah. Afshu salam, wa'timu ta'am, wasilu al-arham. Maintaining ties with your relationships. وَسَلُّوا وَالنَّاسُ نَيَامُ تَدْخُلُ الْجَنَّةَ بِسَلَامُ. I was saying these are the things which will benefit people. And when a person goes in the grave, this is the first question he will be asked. مَنْ رَبُّكَ. Who is your Lord? And so recognizing Allah, it's not the job which feeds people. It's not the qualification and intelligence. And there are many people, especially in our Pakistani community, mashallah, many billionaires can't even sign their names. Angoota chop. About many graduates and MAs and PhDs, masters, they make salam. Salam sahab. And he can't even write his name. MashaAllah. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, 5 times a day. Allah wants us to practice. When we say Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, in salat we hold our hands. Allah wants us to understand, it's not the skill of the hands. Although the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, مَا أَكَلَ أَحَدٌ خَيْرٌ مِّنَ يَأْكُلَ مِّنَ عَمَلِ يَدِي. The best profession, the best way to make a living is with the skill of the hands. If Allah has given you a skill and you can do something with your hands, That is the best way and the purest way to make a living. وَنَبِيَ اللَّهِ دَاوُودْ كَانَ يَأْكُلُ مِنْ عَمَلِ يَدِي. The Prophet ﷺ said, this is the sunnah of Dawood alayhi salam. He used to make a living with the work of his own hands. وَأَلَنَّا لَهُ الْحَدِيدِ. Allah had made metal soft for him. When he would touch any metal, it would become soft and he would mold it and shape it into armor and then sell it. And in spite of being a king, he used to make a living with his own hands. And the Prophet ﷺ said, مَا أَكَلَ أَحَدٌ خَيْرٌ مِّنْ أَنْ يَأْكُلَ مِنْ عَمَلِ يَدِي. Oh, the business is also very good. 9/10 of risk is in business. But the best form of risk is what a person earns with the work of in the skill of his hands. Allahu Akbar. وَأَلَنَّا لَهُ الْحَدِيدِ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had given Dawood alayhi salatu wa salam this skill that metal would become soft. So Allah makes us declare, confess, Ya Allah, it's not with these hands, with the skill that I have, that I survive. Ya Allah, you are the one who provides. Alhamdulillah. And even if I didn't have any hands, and I didn't have any skill, Ya Allah, you can still look after me as you look after the whole universe. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. Animals, young and the old, men and women, mashallah. One man works, but how mashallah, a whole family eats. And Allah gives risk to the strong and the able because of the weak. إِنَّمَا تُنْسَرُونَ وَتُرْزَقُونَ بِذُعَفَائِكُمْ. Allah gives you risk because of the barakah of your weak and elderly. And then that's not sufficient. Allah says, you know, some people might think, okay, not the hand, but I'm very intelligent, I'm very clever. Allah says, put your head on the floor and confess, سُبْحَانَ رَبِّيَ الْأَعْلَى. Put your head down, pick your bottom up. And subhanallah, what a shameful state that is for a person to have his bottom sticking up and his head down on the floor. Make yourself humble and humiliate yourself in front of Allah. Put your head down and raise your bottom and confess. Subhana Rabbi Alala. Ya Allah, you are the glorious. You are my Rabb. You are my Rabb. On the first ayah, Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. Lord of the whole universe. But Ya Allah, especially me. Subhana Rabbi, Ya Allah, you are so glorious. I am so low, my head is on the floor, but Ya Allah, you are the highest. Subhana Rabbi al-A'la, Subhana Rabbi al-Azim. Allah wants us to know who provides. Who provides? Allah provides. So the first thing Allah will ask us, or rather the angels will ask us on behalf of Allah, Allah will send those angels. Angels with long hair. They roll down their backs up to their feet, fiery eyes, thunderous voice. And when he says, Mar Rabbuk, who is your Lord? So jab koi bada aadmi aise baat kare na, to aise waise ko to waise peshab nikal jata hai. You know, when someone big talks to you, someone, it makes you pass water. It happens to people. This is why when a person dies often, most people, sirf peshab hi nahi nikalta, kuch aur bhi saath nikal jata hai. When a person is dying, not just urine, something else flows out as well, because that person is such a state of fear at the time. We can't see. Allah says in the Quran, وَلَوْ تَرَىٰ. If only you could see when angels are taking out the souls of dying people. وَلَوْ تَرَىٰ إِذْ يَتَوَفَّى الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا الْمَلَائِكَةُ يَضْرِبُونَ وُجُوهَهُمْ وَأَدْبَارَهُمْ. If only you could see the angels taking away the souls of people. Allahu Akbar. What a sight that would be when they whip them and they lash them. And when they take out the souls of good people. إِذْ يَتَوَفَّاهُمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ طَيِّبِينَ يَقُولُونَ سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ ادْخُلُوا الْجَنَّةَ بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. Good people, the angels, they say to them, come, let's take you to Allah. Let's take you to Jannah. And he says, I'm ready, I'm coming. The ulama have stated, mashallah, the hoors, the Jannah, the angels, they open the gates to Jannah, and the hoors, they say, come, we're waiting for you. And he says, yeah, I'm coming. I'm coming. And he leaves quickly, mashallah, with smiles. And we've seen people, mashallah, sometimes, if you look at the faces of people who've died, sometimes you can see, mashallah, sometimes people leave with smiles on their faces. And sometimes, Allahu Akbar, Allah, may Allah save us. May Allah grant us all a good khatima, husnul khatima, a good ending. When we leave this world, we leave with iman. And that is why in janazah as well, the dua in janazah, Allahumma man ahyaytahu minna, ya Allah, whosoever you keep alive, fa'ahyihi ala al-islam, keep him alive on Islam. وَمَنْ تَوَفَّيْتَهُ مِنَّا And whosoever you take away, فَتَوَفَّهُ عَلَى الْإِيمَانِ Take him away on iman. May Allah take us all away on iman. May Allah enable us to live like Muslims and die like Muslims and rise like Muslims.